Peninsula 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-ho, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-ho, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. A 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-woo is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-ho, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-woo, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a grim life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-woo is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-woo is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-ho is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. A 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-woo is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-ho, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-woo is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-woo is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-ho, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-ho, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-woo, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-ho is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong. Haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew, when offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-ho is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong. Haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew, when offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-woo, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-ho, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-woo, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-woo is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-woo is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-ho, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-woo, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-ho, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong Seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-woo is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-woo is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020 directed by Yoon Sang-ho is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-ho, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films. 2020, directed by Yoon Sang-woo, is a South Korean action horror film that serves as a standalone sequel to the acclaimed Train to Busan 2016. Set 4 years after the original film's zombie outbreak, Peninsula follows a group of survivors who return to the Korean peninsula, now overrun by zombies, to retrieve a truck filled with money. The film centers on Jong Seok, a former soldier who fled South Korea during the initial outbreak. He is now living in a green life in Hong Kong, haunted by guilt over losing his sister and nephew. When offered a chance to return to Korea to retrieve a truckload of money, he reluctantly agrees. Once back in Korea, Jong-seok and his team encounter a militia group called Unit 631 and a family of survivors. The narrative explores themes of survival, loss, and enduring human spirit amid a post-apocalyptic world. Cultural impact. Peninsula was highly anticipated due to the success of Train to Busan, which had gained international acclaim for its intense action and emotional depth. However, while Peninsula was a commercial success, particularly in Asian markets, it did not achieve the same critical acclaim as its predecessor. The film is often seen as more a conventional action movie than a horror film, lacking the emotional resonance that made Train to Busan a standout in the genre. Awards and nominations. Peninsula was nominated for several awards in South Korea, including at the Blue Dragon Film Awards and the Baeksang Arts Awards. However, it did not win any major awards, reflecting its more lukewarm critical reception compared to Train to Busan. Its achievements were more focused on its technological aspects, such as special effects and action choreography. Trivia and fun facts. Peninsula was initially planned to be more closely linked to Train to Busan, but was later developed as a standalone story set in the same universe. The film was selected for the 2020 Cannes Film Festival, which was cancelled due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The movie was one of the first major South Korean films to release in theaters during the pandemic, making it a significant test case for cinema attendance in the era of COVID-19. Reviews and analysis. Critics were divided on Peninsula. Some praised its high-octane action sequences, visual effects, and film's broader scope compared to its predecessor. However, many critics felt it lacked the emotional depth and character-driven storytelling that made Train to Busan a critical darling. The shift in tone from horror to action was also a point of contention, with some reviewers feeling that it sacrificed the tension and dread that defined the first film. Despite this, Peninsula was appreciated for its world-building and its commentary on human greed and desperation in a world gone mad. Overall, while Peninsula did not quite live up to the legacy of Train to Busan, it remains a noteworthy entry in the zombie genre, especially for fans of action-packed apocalyptic films.